Okay, hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a countdown video on my top 10 favorite Walking Dead characters. Before I get started with the video, I do want to say a few things. First of all, it's Valentine's Day, and I just want to say happy Valentine's Day. Whoever celebrates it, it's not my favorite holiday, to be honest. I think it's a little depressing just because I'm single. But also, Walking Dead returns tonight. It's still on season 6, it just returns from break, and yeah, so I decided to do a countdown video. I don't want to make this video too long because I want this video to get up before the show airs, but I just want to say, as with all my countdown videos or top 10s list, these are always my opinions. You don't have to agree with them. But I would appreciate if you respect them, because I know there's going to be some characters on this list not everyone likes, and I do want to just say, you know, just because you don't like a character doesn't mean everyone else, you know, doesn't too, you know. So, every character has fans, even the most hated characters. I don't accept hate on my channel. I do not tolerate it. I have zero tolerance for hate. So if you comment mean stuff or stuff like that, you're just gonna get blocked and your comments gonna get deleted. So it's pointless. So I respect you on who your favorites are. If you respect me on who my favorites are. So just have that rule in mind, because some people think just because a character is really hated doesn't mean they still have fans. So we are gonna get started. I do have 4 honorable mentions. I have this here for a reason. I'll tell you later, but we're gonna get started with the honorable mention. The first honorable mention goes to Majone. Before I get started, I do want to say it was just released that they're gonna be stopping these kind of figures, which is really, really, really stupid in my opinion. Because they're going to do 7-inch figures, and I think it's just really stupid when they have so many characters they need to make in this scale. So, bad move, and what I'm going to be doing is I'm just going to be getting the characters I need, and I'm probably going to stop collecting McFarlane toys, because I just think it's really, really dumb. I'll probably still collect Walking Dead stuff, but McFarlane toys, unless they do this. I probably won't collect again, just because I think it's a bad move. And yeah, so let's get started. I like Majone. I think she's a very strong, woman. I really like her relationship with Rick and Carl. I like how at first they really didn't accept her, but she made her way into the group, and she's really strong. So we're just gonna put her aside. Next honorable mention is Glenn. I like Lynn. I think, as a group member, he is taken more seriously now, and people respect him more, because I think when the show first started, people didn't really, you know, take him seriously, and people didn't think he could do a whole lot. So I think now, you know, he has that respect that he should have had in the beginning of the show. Number 4 is, no, not number 4, number 3 is, now this character I have a love-hate relationship with, and it is Carl Grimes. Some episodes I really like him, and then some episodes I really, really hate him just because of some things he does. I think, you know, for a kid, he, you know, went through it. He's been through a lot, and he had to grow up really fast, because in that kind of world, it's not a kid's world, and he has, you know, been through a lot, like losing his mother, having to shoot her, and, you know, and just seeing people die around him affects him. So, that's number 3. And number 4 is a character I'm not a huge, huge fan of, but I thought he deserved an honorable mention. He's probably the most popular character, and it's Daryl Dixon. I really did not like Daryl at the beginning of the show. He was just a jerk, and he still can be sometimes, but he's definitely grown up a lot and gotten more mature. I always held that he yelled at Lori. I always held that against him, and just because I didn't like, I don't like it when anyone would be mean to Laurie. But he's definitely gotten a little bit softer. He cares about the people around him more, and it's, you know, he's definitely a nicer person now that he's been through a lot too. So those are the four honorable mentions. I'm just gonna move them a little bit more so we can get the other entries in here. Now, like I said, actually, I'm not sure if I did say this. I won't be talking about the figures as much, but for some of the characters, I do not have the figures, or there's no figures made of them. So, number 10, we're gonna start. Let me get my thing to show you of the character. We're gonna start, and number 10 is Lily. Lily is the sister of Tara. She's a pretty minor character. She was only in about three or four episodes in season four, and I'm not gonna spoil anything that happened recently, but I probably would spoil things that happened in other seasons. And pretty much she met the governor. She didn't know who he was. Kind of started to fall in love with him, kind of like Andrea did. And she kind of got the short end of the stick at the end, and I just really like her. I think she was a little naive about the world, but she was sweet, and she loved her daughter, and you know, and she did supposedly die in the season four mid-season finale, and I think it's a little sad that they killed her off screen, even though, you know, deaths on screen are really sad. But I really would have liked to see more of her. So there's number 9 or 10. Number 9 is Dale. Now, I do not have the Dale action figure yet. I've been seeing him at Target. I can't really afford to pick up anything right now, because I just don't have the money for it. So I'm gonna show you where is he. He is right there. I really like Dale. You know, he tried to keep the old world alive as much as possible, which really wasn't capable. You know, it wasn't really, it just couldn't. But he was a good guy, and he really did care about everyone in the group, except maybe Shane. He was a good guy and just wanted to help people, and, you know, he was a little annoying here and there, but you know, he just cared, that's why. So there is number 9. Number 8 is Maggie. As you saw, Glenn was a honorable mention. I'm just gonna and I really didn't care too much for Maggie when she first appeared, but she's definitely growing on me since like season four, season three. I think she is a strong, you know, she was like Herschel. She really didn't know how to deal with that world, and at first, and she learned, and she got tougher, and she isn't afraid to do things anymore. She's not afraid of walkers anymore. And she is a great character, and I definitely think she's a lot prettier with the longer hair too, to be exact. I think she's a pretty neat character, and she's definitely one of my favorites this season. Number 7 is another character that does not have a figure, and I don't even have a picture of her yet, and it is Deanna. But I did draw her, well, I traced her a while ago. I'm just gonna slip her in behind Lily, and I think Deanna, again, at first I didn't really care for Deanna that much when she first appeared, but she went through a lot. She lost her husband and one of her sons, and I think she was a good leader, and she just wanted Alexandria to survive, and she wanted it to be a little patch in the world that was still there, and people still could live like they did. But unfortunately, it didn't really work out for her in the end. But she tried, and I thought she was a great character. So yeah, and I would love, and it's so sad that they're not going to be keeping up with the 5-inch figures, because I would have loved to see a Deanna figure. Number 6 is Herschel. Again, Herschel grew on me in season 2 a little bit more than Maggie did, but to be honest, he was pretty annoying in season 2 just because he wouldn't accept things, and you know, he still kind of, like Dale thought, the, you know, it could, this, you know, apocalypse could get better, when really it couldn't, and at least not yet. And he thought, you know, the walkers could be cured and, you know, come back. He didn't really realize that it they were dead, and there was no bringing the walkers back. So, but he definitely changed. Unfortunately, his character is dead now. And he definitely did change and got with the picture a little bit. Number 5 is Rick. Rick is probably my favorite male character. But I heard something that might happen in this season, or even in tonight's episode, and if he does it, I'm probably gonna hate Rick. I'm not gonna say what it is, but if he does what I think he's gonna do, I'm really gonna hate Rick, and he'll be off my list. But for now, you know, he's a good leader. He was definitely a lot softer in the beginning, and he got soft. You know, he got so much harder as time went on, just because he's lost so much. He lost his wife that he really loved. Yes, Rick and Lori did really love each other. He just, you know, seen so much death around him. He had to kill his best friend. And he's still a leader, but he's definitely got stronger and harder. And I think he's a good character. Number 4 is another character I do not have a figure of. It is Jesse. Jesse is a fairly new character. She appeared last season, and this is her. And I like Jesse. I knew I probably would. And I'm just gonna say, I don't know, but I am pretty worried for her character tonight, because I think she might die. And I hope she doesn't, because I really like them. And Rick and her kind of just got together, and as much as I loved Rick and Lori together, unfortunately Lori is dead, and she's not going to be coming back, and Rick needs to move on from Lori as much as possible, because it's something Lori would want him to do, and she would want him to find love again. And I think Jesse has a very Lori vibe to her. And I think Jesse reminds him a lot of Lori, and that's one of the reasons he likes her. So I'm really hoping she doesn't die, because I think she needs more time and more development. But so far, I really like her. She's sweet, and I really like that thing she did with the scissors. It was really neat. Number 3 is, I think, a lot of people's favorite, is Carol. First of all, I do want to say, Carol is an awesome, awesome character. She, you know, I always liked her from season 1. She didn't do much in the first 2 seasons. In season 2, she was, you know, pretty much looking for Sophia the whole time. But since season 3, she's definitely gained got a lot stronger, and again, all these characters been through stuff, and when you go through stuff like these characters do, it makes you stronger, it makes you different, it makes you changes, it makes you, you know, think a little bit more about the world, it makes you care about people more, and Carol's definitely that, you know, she cares, but she's stronger and kind of harder, you know. And I do want to say a fun fact, the reason Carol is still alive is because Sarah Wayne Caddies, who played Lori, fought for Carol to stay alive. And I think that was an amazing thing to do. And Sarah was an amazing person and friend to do that for Melissa McBride. And Carol turned into such an amazing character, and I really, really am glad that she's alive, and I really hope she stays alive till the end of the series, because she is the original, the only original female alive, and I think that would be, it would be really, really cool. Number two is, no surprise, I always talk about how much I love the first two characters, and it is Andrea. I know Andrea didn't have a lot of fans. Oops, let me just get this out of Carol's way. Because of things she did in season 3. And honestly, people didn't like her just because she didn't kill the governor. Honestly, I'm just going to say it's so hard to just kill someone like that. And secondly, she fell in love with him. So when you love someone, you don't want to kill them. And third, she didn't realize how bad and evil he was until the very end. But and fourth, she was a really good person, and she went through a lot too that changed her, and she cared. She had a good heart. She was caring. She cared about most everyone around her, and she seen a lot of death too. I mean, she lost her own sister, and that really changed her too, and I thought she was a really awesome character. Again, if you don't like her, that's your opinion, but I love her, and that's not going to change. And I thought she was a really neat, interesting character. And the number one, no surprise there, is Lori Grimes. I am really, really upset that they are stopping the 5-inch line, because I fought so hard for a Lori figure to be made, and now the chances are very, very slim, and there's no excuse why she shouldn't have a figure. I mean, she was a huge character, and she deserved a figure, and she deserves more merchandise. Honestly, she's left out of everything, and it's not fair, and I know she wasn't the most popular character, but look at Hasbro. It doesn't matter what Star Wars character is popular or least popular, they still make even the most background characters. And I think she deserves more merchandise, especially for Lori fans, and it's really not fair. But anyway, I really thought she was an amazing character, one of the best, in my opinion. She slept with Shane. She even tells Dale she only did that to sleep, feel something. When she thought Rick died, she thought she died. She thought she died with Rick during that time, so she really missed him. And yes, she really did love Rick. She was a good mom. She was a really good mom. She protected Carl and loved him the best she could. Yes, he did not listen to her, so a lot of the times he wasn't in the house, but that's his problem. He didn't listen to her. She was a good wife. She did not put Shane and Rick at odds. Shane could have controlled himself a lot better and backed off more. And, you know, she didn't do anything. All she did is tell Rick that he was dangerous, which Shane was very dangerous at that time. And, and she was a good mom and wife. And I don't care what haters say. She was an amazing character as well. And, you know, I just really miss her. And she was strong, not afraid to say what was on her mind or stand up for herself. And she was just a great character, and I'm really bummed that we might not ever get an official figure of her, because this is just a custom I bought off someone. It's not an official figure of her, which looks great and will do, I guess, but I really would love to see a Lori figure in stores. So anyways, that is going to be it for this video. Again, my opinions. I'm just going to take you guys off the tripod, so you guys can see the characters, again. So here are the honorable mentions. Then here's the characters. There's Dale right there. So again, these are just my opinions. Yours might be different. So I would, again, I would love, if you're a fan of The Walking Dead and watch, I would love to see your top 10 favorite characters. So thank you for watching. I hope the episode is good tonight and not too sad, and happy Valentine's Day once again, and until next time, my information is down below, and until next time, have a great day.